We're told to wash fruit and vegetables. So how much bacteria is living on our fresh food?
We found some really interesting and really surprising results.
Our experiment started a week earlier.
We've got your shopping? Okay, let's get started.
We arrive with samples from various supermarkets and grocers. Our first test is to determine if washing is necessary.
We'll test their bacterial levels straight up and for all of these. Then we'll wash it for about 5 seconds under the tap, as most people will do, and then we'll retest it again.
Our second part focuses on products labelled washed and ready to eat. We're comparing them to the same item straight off the shelf.
We're looking at two types of situations. One where, you know, we buy pre-wash, ready-to-eat food.
Convenient.
Convenience in a plastic bag, or we buy it loose.
Each item is carefully measured before being turned into a liquid. It's then put into an incubator for several days. We're testing the total bacteria level, and when we return a week later, our results are in.
I found them amazing, really.
We start with the good news. We tested three apples from three different shops. Washed or unwashed, there's hardly any difference between them.
Apples are fine.
Apples are apples.
Apples are apples.
It's a similar story for tomatoes, strawberries and grapes.
Again, no need to wash them. Don't waste the water. Unless you see visible signs of dirt.
So you can safely eat a grape off the shelf in the supermarket?
Hell,
that's all right.
As long as they don't catch you, I think it's fine.
But let us get to our lettuce results, which is where things get interesting. A piece washed for just 5 seconds has 63,000 microbes per gram. An unwashed section of the same plant has more than six times that amount.
Here we can see obvious difference for the gourmet lettuce between the unwashed and then the washed.
So this tells us that lettuces and leafy veg really do need a wash before eating them.
Absolutely. I think especially anything that there's a chance of visible dirt, then really, you know, rinsing is a good idea.
What about ones that claim to have been already washed?
Have a look at that.
Not what you'd expect.
That's the level of bacteria in a washed, ready-to-eat
this is
bag
lettuce
of lettuce.
That's labelled as washed.
Yeah, washed and ready to go. Way more bacteria.
In fact, there's more than 20 times the amount. Our tests show loose lettuce has 470,000 microbes per gram. The wash leaves out of a packet, 9.5 million.
How big of a difference is that?
Massive.
The results for broccoli, also surprising. Straight from the shelf, it has 280,000 bacteria per gram. Out of a packet labelled washed, the amount grows to 850,000.
I know the conditions they're creating is really promoting the growth of bacteria. Anything that you're chopping up and putting into a bag and sealing and not holding under 5 degrees, those bugs are going to increase.
We're reassured the amount of bacteria found is nothing to panic about, but probably best avoided.
I don't expect there to be pathogens there to make us sick, but you're certainly getting spoilage.
Would you ever buy washed lettuce?
No. No way, Jose.
Gee, that's a shock, isn't it? Surprising results.
Yeah, and when you think too, like, especially like with pregnant women and how dangerous that is with,
Well, you're looking at me. Especially with pregnant women.
You have a pregnant woman at home.
That's true. Is that something to be mindful of?
Yeah.
And this is why I just don't eat veggies of any kind. It's too dangerous.
So smart of you.